Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial. Today we're going to learn how to recreate this YouTube intro animation using Linearity Move. Let's get started. When I first open the app, I'm going to see the home screen. To create a new document, I click the plus button. Here, I can pick the resolution of my new document or import an existing file. I can import a file from Curve, Linearity's design tool, or connect to Figma and import a design from there. I'm going to select this curve file and hit the import button to enter the Scene Builder panel. I tap and hold on the static artboard and I drag it to the Scene Builder line at the bottom of the panel. I can also change the duration of the scene from here. I increase the time to 10 seconds. When I am done, I click the import button. Let's start animating. I select the first text object. I explore the preset panel on the right and I select the fade in preset. When I select a preset animation, one or multiple transitions are applied to my selected object, and keyframes automatically appear on the timeline. I bring the playhead back to the beginning and I switch to design mode. I select the shape tool and I draw a rectangle directly on the canvas. To create a perfect square, I tap the screen with my free hand. I switch to the node tool. I select the bottom right corner of my shape and I delete it. I use the style panel on the right to uncheck the fill option. In the layer panel at the bottom left corner of the screen, I tap and hold on the shape layer. I select the send to back option. My transparent shape needs to be behind another object to be used as a mask. To create a mask, first I activate the multi-selection button to select both the transparent object and the oval. Then I select the mask icon from the quick action menu on the screen and the job is done. I open the mask group and I select the rectangle. I resize the mask to hide completely the oval. I switch back to animate mode. I move the playhead to second one and I change the size of the rectangle to reveal the oval. I select the main title and open the preset panel on the right. This time, I'm going to apply a mask animation in just one click. I select the mask reveal preset and the job is done. Next, I select the first label under the title and I apply a new preset animation called flicker. I select the second label and I apply the same preset animation. For the last time, I apply this preset to the third label. I move to the timeline and I open the animation dropdown to edit the keyframes. I select the first keyframe of each animation and I delete it. This way, each label's starting stage will be at 0% opacity. Time to animate the video stills in the background. I activate the pin icon. Pinning is a smart feature that helps me quickly define the start and end points of my next transition. I select the second pin and I move it to extend the duration of the highlighted segment. I move it all the way to second 8. I move the playhead back to the start and I change the position of the gallery using the style panel. I pinch the timeline with my fingers to zoom in and I move the playhead to second 5. I change the position of the gallery to the opposite side using the alignment options in the style panel. I don't need to add the last keyframe because pinning remembers the starting position of the gallery and adds the last keyframe automatically. I change the position of the pins to highlight a 1 second segment between second 8 and second 9. I move the playhead to second 9. I double tap on the gallery group to select the image at the center of the screen. I tap and drag the green dot around the bounding box to scale the image and cover the entire canvas. I bring the playhead to second 8. I activate the multi-selection button. I select all the text layers and I apply the fade out preset. Now, the YouTube intro is ready to be added at the beginning of my next vlog. I can also swap the images in the gallery with stills from a different vlog. I can switch to design mode, change images and fonts in line with the new vibe. I can also change the copy on my text to reflect the content of a different video. When I am done with the edits, I switch back to animate mode, and all the animations are still working. When I'm ready, I can export my animation by selecting the drop arrow on the top left corner and selecting the label Export. Here, I can preview my animation one last time before exporting it. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you found this tutorial useful. You can learn more about Linearity Move and animation from the Learn tab on the home screen. Let's bring our stories to life with Linearity Move.